remember the first time I fell in love. I was in high school, and it was that first time where you fall in love, and you're just like, this is it. I found her. I'm 17 years old, and I'm done, you know? Her name was Amanda, and she was like adorable and funny. And what was really exciting for me is that she was like a delinquent. Like, I was like this play by the rules school citizen, and she had been expelled from her previous school for dealing acid, which I thought was a really strong quality. Like, at one point, she was like, it was totally messed up because it wasn't even me, it was this other girl, and I was framed. And I was just like, awesome. Like, no one would ever frame me for anything. I thought it was like an opposites attract situation. She wanted to know what it was like to hang out with someone in student government who writes for the newspaper. And I wanted to know what it was like to be cool. At one point, I was like, do you want to write an article for the newspaper? She goes, I don't want to write an article. I want to do things people write articles about. I was like, good answer. I find that when you fall in love, you tend to overlook certain red flags. One of them was that she would say really mean stuff to me, but then she would pull it back. She'd be like, no one likes you at all. Only kidding. Or like, you're like a nerd, but you're not even smart. Just joking. Can't choose who you love. Second red flag with Amanda was that she was a liar. And I don't mean that in an offensive way. Like, lying was kind of like it's like a sport at the school I was at. I transferred from the all-boys school to this co-ed school. There was this one guy in my class named Keith Robbins who was a legendary liar. You'd know when he was lying because he would lick his finger like a bookie, and he would dart his eyes from side to side. And he'd go, yeah, yeah, nice, nice, you know? And he wasn't even handling money. Like, I don't even know what this is about. And then he would lie about things that were sort of insignificant. He'd be like, yeah, my uncle's Tony Robbins, motivational speaker. Yeah, nice, you know? And we found out that that wasn't even true, but even if that were true, that wouldn't be impressive to a bunch of high school students. But I think that's the Jedi level of lying, is you lie about little stuff and no one notices when you're lying about big stuff. It's like banking.